Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. The United Nations Human Rights Chief has warned of a looming catastrophe in southern Syria as government forces pressed ahead with an offensive in rebel-held areas after the ending of a 12-hour truce in the strategic province of Daraa. High Commissioner for Human Rights Zaid Raad al-Hussein said in a statement on Friday that there was a grave risk that intensified fighting will see many civilians trapped, condemning how civilians in Syria continue to be used as pawns by the various parties. Syrian government forces launched the military push on June 19, aiming to retake the southern provinces of Daraa, Quetta and parts of Suweida, still mostly held by opposition fighters. The UN estimates that up to 50,000 people have fled the embattled areas in southern Syria in recent days, but the opposition puts the number at double that figure, or about 100,000. With Russian air support, forces loyal to President Bashar al-Assad have retaken territory and continue to progress southwards where the last pockets of opposition remain. Al-Hussein said his office received reports that, in the last few days, civilians at some government checkpoints in the southern, eastern and western parts of Daraa have only been allowed through to government-held areas in Daraa City and Suweida Governorate for a fee. To add to the bleak situation facing civilians, there are also reports that ISIL fighters in control of the Yarmouk basic area in the western part of Daraa Governorate are not allowing civilians to leave the areas under their control. Zaid emphasized the warring factions' responsibility towards civilians under international law, which mandates that they do their utmost to protect civilians and provide safe passage to those wishing to flee. Earlier on Friday, a temporary truce in Daraa between government forces and the rebel group Free Syrian Army, FSA, brokered by Russia and Jordan, ended at noon local time, 9 o'clock Greenwich Mean Time. Later in the day, a Jordanian official told Reuters news agency that a new ceasefire had been agreed upon by the Syrian government and rebels, but did not offer further details. However, a U.S. Department of State official said the U.S. could neither confirm nor deny the truce report and described the situation in southern Syria as grim, with Syrian government forces and Russia continuing to bomb the area. Daraa province is a strategic region that extends along the border with Jordan and the occupied Golan Heights. Until recently, it was part of a U.S.-backed and negotiated truce. In the town of Al-Musayfira in eastern Daraa, air attacks that targeted an underground shelter left 17 dead, including 11 children, the worst single incident since the Syrian government offensive began in the area on June 19, according to DPA news agency. That brings to at least 96 the total number of civilians killed, including 19 children, since the offensive in Daraa began, according to reports. The violence has raised concerns about the humanitarian situation in the province. Hezbollah-affiliated Al-Mayadeen TV said Syrian government troops had opened three crossing points in rebel-held territory for civilians wishing to flee to the other side. Syrians fleeing the fighting and are heading towards neighboring Jordan have been denied entry, with authorities there claiming to not have the resources to deal with a new wave of refugees. Jordan already has 1.3 million Syrians. Our country has reached its maximum capacity. Jordan has been shouldering this responsibility, and I must say, we've been doing so alone, Jordanian Foreign Minister Ayman Safadi said on Thursday. Daraa is considered the cradle of the anti-government uprising that erupted in Syria in March 2011, after a series of arrests sparked protests that spread across the country,